Today we're up in Michigan to see how race ethanol is made out of corn.
Cool to be here at the ethanol plant today, just to see how there's just this huge closed loop that happens, starting with the cow. So we make corn to feed to our cows, but when we have extra corn, we can bring it here as a great market to sell our corn to the ethanol plant. Then the byproduct that they make from the ethanol is distiller's grains. We can bring that right back to our farm, feed it to our cows. They can make milk, and they also make manure, which then we use as fertilizer for the corn. We grow more corn, then we get more ethanol and more milk again. It's a great closed loop.
We buy 19 million bushels a year at this production facility. It's brought to the facility by the farmer, where it is tested for quality control and make sure that it meets our quality standards. That corn is then stored in a silo until it's ready for processing. The first step in processing is milling, or grinding that corn into a flour so that it can be transferred into our ethanol production process. Ground corn contains four major components: starch, protein, fat, and fiber. Starch is the main component that we use to create ethanol. That starch gets converted into a fermentable sugar, and that fermentable sugar gets converted to ethanol in fermentation. The protein, fat, and fiber are along through the ride for most of this process until it can be converted into a high-value animal feed. That corn is then conveyed into our slurry tank, where we add hot water and enzymes. Hot water and starch form a thick, viscous, doughy mixture. The enzymes that we add help to break that down into a thin, pumpable liquid. That liquid is then heated and sent to our liquefaction tanks. The purpose of liquefaction is for us to add more enzymes and to start the conversion of starch to sugar. Once sufficient residence time has happened, it's then pumped into fermentation. The purpose of fermentation is to convert those fermentable sugars into ethanol. And we do that by adding yeast and additional enzymes. The finished product of fermentation is beer, containing 20% alcohol or ethanol by volume, along with water and excess solids remain from the corn. This beer needs to be further refined by pulling the ethanol out and separating it from the water and those solids in order to be used in an engine. We do that through distillation. Distillation allows us to come up with a 190 proof product, which then needs further refinement via the molecular sieves to get our final product at 200 proof. The molecular sieves takes our 190 proof product, it pulls out the excess moisture, and the result is a 200 proof ethanol, where we then send to our product storage tanks. It's now ready to be blended with our One Ethanol's performance package.
Stay tuned for part two as we learn more about using ethanol for fuel.